I'm out of it. What's the matter with you, Norman? Brought you a little bag?
Hello again, this is Peter Bradshaw from The Guardian. This is my 10th lockdown vlog. Thank you, thank you. The film of the week is possibly the film of the year. Da Five Bloods by Spike Lee.
Black GI, is it fair to serve more than the white Americans that sent you here? Nothing is more confused than to be ordered into a war to die without the faintest idea of what's going on. I dedicate this next record to the soul brothers of the 1st Infantry Divisions. Be safe.
Gentlemen, welcome back to Vietnam.
Look at that sound.
You're the man in all his glory.
Who was that guy?
That brother was the best damn soldier that ever lived.
We bury it. They don't. We come back and collect.
The love has flown away. Hey! My tears have come and gone.
Hey! I'm tempted to say cometh the hour, cometh the insurgent filmmaker, but the hour came with Trayvon Martin, before that with Rodney King, or with innumerable other examples. The hour has been coming forever. And Spike Lee has been here all along. Four African-American veterans of the Vietnam War, played by Delroy Lindo, Clark Peters, Isaiah Whitlock Jr. and Norm Lewis, show up in Vietnam on something very much more than a trip down memory lane. They are haunted by the memory of their fallen company commander, Norman, nicknamed Stormin' Norman, played by Chadwick Boseman. They want to honour his memory, but they also want to rediscover a cache of stolen gold bullion, originally intended to pay South Vietnamese troops, which they found on the field of battle and had to abandon. Da Five Bloods is a paintball gun filled with real bullets. Lee splatters moods, ideas, genres, archive clips all over the screen. There are references to Apocalypse Now, to Rambo, to the treasure of the Sierra Madre. It also feels like something like Godard's Le Petit Soldat. Da Five Bloods is about race and the American Empire, about the evergreen wound of Vietnam, about African-American sacrifices on the field of battle, and how, in peacetime, those sacrifices go on as slaughters or murders. It feels at first like a satire or a black comedy, and those two things are an important part of the film's unstable energy. And yet in the final 15 minutes, there's an overwhelming upsurge of emotion. All the mischief, all the anarchy has been leading to this devastating aria of emotion. Da Five Bloods is available now on Netflix. This is the 25th anniversary of the famous or notorious film Showgirls, from director Paul Verhoeven and screenwriter Joe Esterhaz, starring Elizabeth Berkley as Nomi, the tough, sexy dancer who comes to Las Vegas yearning to make it in the bafflingly unprestigious world of hotel entertainment floor show erotica. Now a new documentary entitled You Don't Know Me from filmmaker Jeffrey McHale tells the strange and fascinating story of how this film was at first reviled as a critical disaster, then gigglingly celebrated as a so bad it's good kitsch fest, and then finally straight up admired as a misunderstood masterpiece of Hollywood melodrama.
Absolutely no one under the age of 17 is allowed.
I don't think they have an attractive star. They don't do anything original in the screenplay. I didn't care for the film.
Lousy movie.
Really lousy acting.
It was a disaster.
It's kind of raunchy.
Very, very bad.
Let me guess. Worst movie? Showgirls.
Showgirls. You got it.
Good guess.
Welcome to Vegas.
I just got here.
Okay, yes, it's a failed movie.
Where are you from?
But it adds up to something.
Different places.
A type of comedy I don't think you can make on purpose, which makes it very rare and valuable.
I hadn't seen something so perfectly bad in years. It was done. Civilization had done its job.
This is an amusing and watchable documentary, but it never quite makes up its mind as to whether or not we should be celebrating Showgirls ironically or unironically. There are, in fact, very few films that go through what I call the three ABBA stages. At first critically reviled, then ironically indulged, and then straightforwardly and universally celebrated. The Sound of Music, oddly not mentioned here, is one of these films, and also, possibly, might have been Nick Rey's exotic western Johnny Guitar, which, without the passionate support of its superfan Jean-Luc Godard, might itself be saddled with an ironized reputation. You don't know me as fun as indeed is Showgirls, but as time goes on, I keep thinking that life is too short for so bad it's good, and we should be looking for so good it's good. Thanks again for all your comments. If you like this vlog, or even if you don't, please share it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, CFAX, and Teletext, and tell all your friends to subscribe.